Okay, while waiting your friend may be still busy and I don't know why your friend join in this meeting. We will discuss about unit 16. So let me for share screen. Okay. Yeah. Read about reading, but before we discuss it, the last all of you finish for send your assignment in Spada. Finish or not?
Saya belum, sir, soalnya Spada tadi error.
Okay, and then?
Tapi sudah saya kerjakan kok.
Only you, so all finish.
Not yet, sir.
Sepadanya error.
Yes. So because actually I give information to your class captain that all of this segment have to finish on yesterday. And then because you say that there is error in Spada system, so I will look it again and then. Me, you can share your assignment by my WhatsApp. Ya, jadi nanti bisa dikirim ke WhatsApp saya, enggak apa-apa. I send the number in Spada. Ada di grup itu kan ada nomornya saya, itu bisa di cek nanti. Because only stay in unit 16. I will give you one assignment more before we discussing and have review for this our discussion. Jadi nanti kita akan diskusikan kembali itu semua tugas-tugas harapan saya sudah selesai. Ada satu tugas yang harus kalian kerjakan untuk di unit 16. Ya. Itu aja nanti dicek di Spada. So you can look and check your Spada. Is okay? So do you understand what I mean?
Yes, sir.
Okay, maybe there is question or it is okay or go on. If there is problem, so may you can ask me, then I will solve your problem by giving explanation. So you can understand with my assignment. It's okay, yeah? And then you can prepare on your book and open in unit 16. Then look on your screen. Read about reading. Yes. We know that a read, yeah, is one of the what's that? Important English skill. One of them is reading. Maybe why? Okay. So my question, why reading is very important for us in improving our English skill? Who can answer it? Okay, why? Why reading is very important for us. Hersi. Yes, Hersi. You may answer, Hersi. Hello, Hersi.
Sir.
Okay, yes. So you may your answer. Like what? May you have the reason, okay, based on your experience, why reading is very important for us in improving our English skill. Maybe why?
I think reading is important because reading is can open our knowledge,
okay,
and can also memberikan pengalaman, giving
experiences.
Experiences through the story in the book.
Okay. This one Kellogg by you, okay, that I agree with your opinion. Besides experiences, you know about it all, yes? So it's belong to literacy, okay? And then maybe Tan, how about you? Okay, Hersi said like that, and then how about you?
I think with reading we can teach a new word or vocabulary.
Vocabulary. And then after vocabulary, only vocabulary.
Improve our memory.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I feel like that.
Okay, and then how about there? How about there? There or Ella? Go. Ayo.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, what's your opinion? How about you? My question in this meeting as the introduction for you all, that I ask why reading is very important for us in improving our English skill. Yeah, why? Yeah, why?
To understand mm-hmm. about information.
Good, to understand about information or to receive the information. Which one is the first? Which one is the first?
Pardon me, sir. Repeat.
Yes, you say that about the information. Yes, our KELAC is information. You say that information. Okay, can understand about information. So I ask you, which one is the first? Understand about information or receive about the information? Kira-kira yang mana? Kira-kira receive information dulu atau gimana? Dea? Atau Ella? How about you, Ella? May you have another reason? Well, Ella?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. You only stay yes, sir. So, how about you?
Bisa ulang pertanyaannya, sir?
Why reading is very important for us in improving our English skill?
Melalui reading, we can learn many things, like find some information,
okay.
And kita juga bisa belajar pronunciation.
Oh. What? Study about?
Pronunciation.
Pronunciation. Well, stay when you remember, when you are child. Yeah? When you are child. Coba diingat kembali ketika kamu masih kanak-kanak. When you learn in primary school, the most important is calistung. You may ever look calistung, baca, tulis, hitung. Yes, account, and then read, then write. Yes, all of you, we agree with you all that after reading, we can receive some information, receive the information, and then Tan say that experience. Yeah. It is very good because Tan says like Albert Einstein. Yeah, Albert Einstein say that the best learn is experiences. Pembelajaran terbaik itu kan pengalaman. Nah, pengalaman salah satunya tadi dapat karena membaca tadi. Dan katanya begitu bilangnya. Okay, so what kind of things have you read in this section in unit 16? What kind of that? What type of reading that you have in our lecture? Nah, perkuliahan kita itu membahas tentang membaca seperti apa. Like what? Oh ya, udah satu semester lo ini. Huh? What's the name of your lecture? What's the name of your subject? Critical reading, all right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so, what happened in critical reading and what have we do? Why we have to critique, or there is critical, or on, not only for reading but there is critical reading. Mengapa kok membaca itu harus kritis gitu ya? Kok enggak hanya cukup membaca saja? Why? If you look, one important is the component of what's that? 21 centuries, yeah. 21 centuries. There are some subject, and one of them is critical. Nah, ya. Kompetensi abad 21 itu salah satunya adalah berpikir kritis. By critical reading, so I hope you all, I hope in this class, not only can take the conclusion after having lecture, but you can construct, you can build up your mind. So maybe there is a range by yourself. Ya, kita harus berpikir kritis itu kenapa? Ya, karena bangsa kita itu sebenarnya dari dulu ya begitu-begitu aja. Maka dari itu pembelajaran abad 21 diarahkan ke hal-hal yang kritis. That's why, oleh karena itu, that's why our lesson have to be stay in higher order thinking skill. It's called by Hodge, ya. Maka pembelajaran perkuliahan itu harus juga mengarah kepada higher order thinking skill. What does it mean? Higher order thinking skill. Cara berpikir tingkat tinggi. Apalagi kalian di perguruan tinggi. Higher order thinking skill. It is called by Hodge. Ya, perkuliahan Hodge, pembelajaran Hodge. Ya, okay. So how many language do you read regularly? Maybe? Yuk, answer it. Ayo dijawab cepat ini. Kita diskusikan cepat-cepat aja, enggak apa-apa. How many language do you read regularly? Berapa banyak bahasa?
Maybe just two.
Two? What kind of that? Indonesian?
And English.
Indonesian, English? Japanese, if you are from Java, Maduranese, if you are from Madura, like that. So how many? Huh? Two, three, ya? Okay. Is there any other language that you have? Ini siapa nih? Fitron, Fitron. How about you, Fitron? I love it.
In my opinion, I have four languages.
Yes, what are they?
They are Indonesian.
Okay. It is second language or mother language? Indonesian.
My mother language is Japanese.
Japanese, okay. And then?
And then English.
English.
Especially English and Japanese.
Japanese. Wow, it's good. Very good. Yeah. Are you have lecture in Japan?
No, but in senior high school, it is my one of my subjects.
Okay, so you from languages subject, yes?
Yes.
Department of your senior high school.
In senior high school, I in science, but one of my subject is Japan language.
Okay, good, thank you. And then think about this question. How important is reading in our everyday lives? Karina, how important is reading? It is not too different with my first question, okay? In introduction, how important is reading in our lives?
I think it's important, sir.
Mm-hmm. Like because, what?
Because when we are reading, we know about something new.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good.
For example, when we are learning about critical reading,
mm-hmm.
and we learn about new chapter, so we know good. About new information.
Okay, thank you very much. Yes. Okay, so what kind of depth it is called by the way to find out some information? Yeah, it is the way to find out some information. Almost everything that I know in English, for example, okay, maybe you can take reading text, start from books. Okay, what another? Only books? Paper. What again?
Newspaper.
Newspaper. Then?
Magazine.
Magazine. Okay, what again?
Article.
Article. Okay, and then?
Letter.
Well, go on. We know that e-book, electronic book, is okay?
Yes, sir.
Ah, yes, because now we have to combine our lecture by using the education technology. So it's called by EduTech. Okay. And then label voucher, yeah, doctor prescription. You know prescription?
Recept, sir.
Okay, good. Yes, prescription. Actually, after if you are if you got influenza or the other, yes, then you visit the doctor, then the doctor check up you, and after that, doctor will give you the prescription. Then after that, you will go to the drugstore. Okay, go on. Well, we start from point A. Okay, point A, I will call Tiara. Go on, Tiara, in point A. Look at the statement below about reading. Do you agree with them? Check the boxes. Like what? Go on.
Reading is the act of getting meaning from printed or written words.
Uh-huh. What's that? So which one? I agree, I disagree, I don't know. Reading is the act of the getting meaning from printed on written words. So it is free or not?
I agree, sir.
It's free. It depends on yourself. Yeah. Okay. And then point B. Go. Point B.
People may read hundreds or thousands of words a day without even looking at the book, newspaper, or magazine.
So, what's your answer? People may read 100 or 1,000 of words a day without even looking at book, newspaper, or magazine. Agree or not? Based on your experiences. Based on your experience.
Agree, sir.
Okay, next. Go. Then?
In the simplest sense, reading means recognizing letters and groups of letters as symbols and stand for particular sound.
Particular. Okay, repeat again. Particular.
particular.
Okay. So, what's that? The symbol sense reading means recognizing letters and group of letters as symbol. Agree or not? If there is symbol by readings. Bisa disimpulkan enggak reading itu? Ayo. Bisa enggak kita membaca apa? Simbol gitu. Agree or not? Ayo, who can help? In point C. Ayo. Who can help? Ayo. Maybe Tan or Afif. Okay, in the simple sense, reading means recognizing letters and groups of letters as symbols that stand for a particular sound. Agree or not? Hello, everybody. Do you agree or not with point C? Yes, Tiara? Ayo, in point C. Hello? Well, don't be silent. Okay, in point C. Like what? Do you agree or not?
I agree.
Okay, yes. So you can give me example. Give me one example. Well, like what? Indi. Ya, beri satu contoh Indi. Gimana? In the simple sense, reading means recognizing letter and groups letter as the symbols. Gimana? Contohnya gimana? You may show it. Hersi, help your friend Hersi. Ayo Hersi. What's that? Is there any trouble with your microphone? Ada trouble tuh?
Aku kasih ini layarnya.
Indi, dicek dulu mikrofonnya, ada trouble itu. You have trouble with your microphone. For using symbol, maybe graphic, you know, you ever diagram graphic itu ya, dibaca kan dibaca itu kan simbol, simbol angka macam-macam, graphic naik turun, when the graphic will go up and go down, yes, okay, then point D, so I will call you Nailil, ayo Nailil, point D Nailil.
Yes sir. In most case, the teaching of reading stresses certain skills such as word recognition, vocabulary development, and comprehension or understanding of reading matter.
Like what? Your experience that you ever do in your activity. Agree or not? Do you agree or not? In most cases, the teaching of reading stresses certain skills such as word recognition, then understanding of reading matter. Kira-kira agree enggak? Setuju enggak itu? Setuju ya? Oke.
Okay. I agree.
Oke. Okay. And then, Marky. Point to Marky. The statement. Go on. Yuk, Marki. Muhammad Marki Winata. Silakan. Ini, ayo. Marki, nggak ada. Kok pasif sekali ya kelasmu ini ya? Saya rasa sangat pasif sekali ini. Kurang aktif sekali. Ini ada banyak alasan ya. There are some reason. You understand? You comprehend or not, ya? You read or not. Nah, itu ada banyak faktor di sini. Kita lihat literasinya sangat rendah sekali ya. Oke, Tan, ayo Tan, bantu Tan. Discussing for yes, number sir. 2, 4.2, discussing, help your friend, okay?
Okay. Number 2, it is the essential. It is specific to learning and one of the most important skills in everyday life. Reading provides the key to all kinds of information. It enables us to learn how to build or fix things, to enjoy stories, to discover what other people believe, and to develop ideas and beliefs of our own.
Okay. So which one is paragraph? A, B, C, D?
I think it is from paragraph A.
A, good. Okay. Why? Because? Why? Because? Hello? Yes, all right. It is okay. So it is A. Yeah, I agree with you. Reading is the act of getting meaning from printed or written words. Well, okay. Then we are going to the learning trip. Okay. When we read a long text for the first time, we usually skim it in order to find out the general meaning and to identify the parts which we want to read in detail. The most important parts of text are the first paragraph, which introduces the several topics, and the first sentences of each of the other paragraphs. The sentence usually introduces the topic of the paragraph. Okay, let's discuss for point three. Point three, number three. Okay. Well, I will call you ayo, ini tadi dipanggil saya enggak ada ya, Gagarin ayo Gagarin.
Yes sir.
Ya, go on. Di number three.
Read the extract from the entry on the right and underline the most important points.
Mm-hmm. What's that? Read the extract from the entry on the right and underline. Nah, di sebelah kanan itu kan ada banyak itu. Yang kira-kira yang di underline itu gimana? Poinnya seperti apa? Pentingnya itu di mana? Yang pertama apa kira-kira? People. The first is people.
People differ.
In reading ability. People differ in reading ability. So, all of the student here, like you all, yeah, have differences. It cannot be same between one and others. So you have any technique for reading based on yourself, by on your experiences, maybe one of your friend reading by listening to the music, can be concentration, this okay, yeah? Sometimes if you look the Western people, whenever they go, they visit some place, they always bring books like that, yeah? It is very different based on our habit and our environment. Okay, and then the next, the second was that, the second. A good reader, yeah, a good reader.
A good reader uses various reading techniques.
Okay, it's very important. Good reader uses various reading techniques. So like what? Like what? Various reading techniques.
Skimming and scanning, sir.
Skimming, scanning. And then, what again? Is there any intensive reading you ever hear? Skimming, intensive reading, and then, and now we have critical reading. So it's belong to technique or not, or variants of reading. Okay. Well, and then, the third, yang ketiga apa? reading can be
classified into three main kinds.
Okay.
Number one, occasional reading. Number two, study writing. Number three, survey reading.
Okay, good. And then the next. Selanjutnya. Ayo, masih Kak Karin, habiskan itu sampai 9 itu.
Number 4, sir.
Yes, number 4. What's that number 4?
Are any of ideas in the extract new to you? Mm-hmm. Which was?
Yes. What's that? Are any the ideas in the extract new to you? Which one? Which one, Kak Karin? Which one? Fitron, maybe help Gagarin. Ayo, which one? Gimana? Which one can provide it? Siapa bisa bantu? Who can help? Gagarin, what is your answer? Kalau Gagarin sendiri gimana jawabnya itu? Yes or no? Are any of the ideas in the extract new to you? Yes or not?
Maybe yes, sir.
Then which one?
Maybe yes, sir.
So which one? Kira-kira yang mana? Recreational reading. Can provide hour after hour enjoyment. Then number 5, which of the three reading styles? Ya, yang mana? Gayanya itu yang mana? Gaya membaca seperti apa? Oke. Okay. Pak, ini ayo Fitron, the answer Fitron. Number 5. Ayo Fitron.
Which of the three reading styles, recreational, study type, survey, have you used to read this extract?
Mm-hmm. Which one?
For me, it will be that survey reading, sir.
Survey reading?
Because I ever read about survey for my essay. And that's it, sir.
Okay. If you look for the study type reading, usually requires the reader to pay close attention to the text. And then survey reading involves conferring a large amount of the text, get a general idea of its contents. You know general? What is general? In each paragraph, each text, there is main idea. There is conclusion. So called by deductive paragraph or inductive paragraph. Which one is the position of main idea? Yes, it is in front of the sentence, in front of the paragraph, or behind of the paragraph. If behind, we call by conclusion. Yes or not? If in the first, we call it, what's that?
Deduction.
No. My question, if you ever look, the position of main idea in the first paragraph and behind of the or the end of the paragraph, it's called by the sentence when we find it in behind. You say okay, deductive and inductive. So it is same or different?
Same, sir.
Hey, same. Are you sure?
Different, sir.
Different. Different. The position of mind idea is different. Jadi paragraf deduksi, paragraf induktif itu juga berbeda. Nah, itu nanti arahnya ke sana. Arahnya nanti ke sana. teksnya itu arahnya nanti ke sana. Oke. Okay. Then in point 6, read the extract again, circle the correct phrases so that sentences are true. The first mean information. And then which point B? Kira-kira yang mana ini? Ya.
Types of text.
Mm-hmm. And then?
And then he like.
And then after that?
D.
Point D. When we do study, what? What's that?
Link the main ideas together.
Link the main ideas together, and then with survey reading, we read everything, only some parts carefully.
Only some parts.
And then beginner find reading easier if the text is language that they know. Yes or not?
They know.
Yes, yes or not? How about you? Now you stay in the fourth semester. It is called by beginner or intermediate or up level. If you based on your position now, which one?
I think advanced.
Advanced.
Or intermediate.
Yes, advanced because you stay in university. Yes or not? Yeah. If there is beginner, when we are child, when you stay in kindergarten or primary school or junior high school, because there is position different, yes, different position about the English. When we study English, when we learning English, some school in primary, yes, okay, there is an English teacher, but some school there is no English teacher. Ini juga berbeda. Jadi dasar itu nggak bisa disamakan, ya, berbeda, ya. Dikatakan pemula itu beda. Contoh, tadi kasih sekolah itu ada yang SD ada bahasa Inggris dan ada yang SD nggak ada bahasa Inggris. Tapi kalau di kota besar saya yakin ada semua bahasa Inggrisnya. Nah kalau SD nggak ada bahasa Inggris baru dimulai, ya, start from junior high school. So when they stay in junior high school, it is called by beginner. Nah, maka kalau mereka yang memulai pembelajaran bahasa Inggris itu di tingkat SMP, karena di SD tidak ada bahasa Inggris, ya, SMP itu dia sebut sebagai pemula. Yes or not? Oke, ya, jelas ya sini ya, paham sekali ya. Oke, yes. Then we are going, before we go to the point 7, I will call you, where is, yeah, only how many person? Yomi, is there Yomi? Marcelina? Is there, are you Marcelina?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Marcelina, read, please, about the text. Kinds of reading. Go on.
Kinds of reading. People differ in reading ability. For example, those who have been reading a long time tend to understand what they have read more quickly and more automatically than junior readers. In addition, other readers bring more background experience to their reading. They can use their experience to fill in important information that is not clearly stated in the text. A good reader uses various reading techniques. The techniques depends on the type of difficulty of the material, the purpose of for reading it, and the readers of own language development and familiarity with the subject. Reading can be classified into three main kinds. Point 1, recreational reading. Point 2, study type reading, and point 3, survey reading. Good readers can easily shift from one kind to another, depending on their purpose for reading and on the material itself.
Okay, stop. So now go on, Hersi.
Recreational reading. Recreational reading can provide hour after hour of enjoyment. When reading a story purely for pleasure, most people read at a relaxed, uneven speed. They may skim through a tale until they come to a scene, a description, or even a phrase that is especially pleasing or satisfying. That portion may be read slowly and then reread to be enjoyed, appreciated, or considered. Number 2, study type reading. Study type reading usually requires the reader to pay close attention to the text. A good reader looks for significant ideas and details. The reader then tries to understand how those ideas and details relate to one another and how they fit into the general topic. Reading speed tends to be slower the first time study type material is read, and the reader may need to reread portions of the text to understand it fully. Reading speed may be much faster when the material is reviewed.
Okay, number stop. 3. Okay, thank okay. you. Yeah, thank you. Good. And then Karina.
Survey reading involves covering a large amount of text to get a general idea of its content. In such cases, the person may first skim the material to understand the main point. The reader may then look for details that reinforce or illustrate that point. The person may then read some sections carefully to make sure that the desired information has been found. Shifting among kinds of reading. Most people use different reading techniques for different reading situations. For example, a mystery enjoyed simply for entertainment may be read rapidly, but in classic Russian novel may call for slow, careful reading. Technical texts that could lead to job advancement or that tell how to fix something usually require thoughtful reading.
Okay, stop.
Good readers can
Thank
easily.
Hello. Okay, then Ella. Go on, Ella.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, go on.
Good readers can easily see from one kind of reading to another. For instance, a student collecting information to write a paper might begin surveying articles to see if they fit the topic. One article may lead the student to consider changing the topic. And so the article is studied thoroughly and another topic chosen. While surveying for the new topic, the student looks another topic. The student looks for information to create an outline. During the survey reading, the student may see an entertaining article and read it for pleasure. Reading flexibility improves with experience. Beginners may tend to read everything somewhat awkwardly, advancing slowly word by word because they doubt their ability to recognize words. By reading materials that follow their own language patterns, that is familiar words and sentences they use, even beginning readers can read with both speed and understanding. In time, they learn that different reading materials make different demands on their abilities.
Okay, answer number 7, Ella. Go. Yeah, answer number 7.
Does the text describe your experiences as a reader of your own language and of other language?
Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
Why? Because?
When I was a beginner in English, I read the words slowly, word by word.
And then?
But now I can read a sentence or a paragraph better than before.
Okay, thank you. So, number 8. Orangnya hanya ini aja ya. Number 8, coba diulang lagi kalau gitu. Karina, ya, yeah, number 8.
What advice would you give to someone who wanted to improve their reading?
What advice would you give to someone who wanted to improve their reading skill? Ya, yeah, Karina. So, like what?
Practice to reading continuously.
Practice to reading or practice for reading? If you say practice to add verb one. Kalau to itu dia harus diikuti V1 ya. Kalau to katakan to read. Kalau menggunakan gerund, ing, tambahkan for sebelumnya. Tadi kalau menggunakan to, pakai V1. Nah, diulang.
Practice for reading continuously.
Okay. And then, what again?
And then,
after that.
For knowing about correct pronunciation, we can use a dictionary.
Okay. Nah, I will give you the example because you will be the teacher. I will ask you, okay? All of you will be a teacher, an English teacher. Ini semua kan nanti akan jadi guru bahasa Inggris, loh. Ya. Yeah. Ya yeah, enggak?
Yes, sir.
Ayo, ini penting sekali ya bagi kalian, penting sekali untuk bangsa ini. Ayo, tolong di ini aku akan matikan dulu materi ini, akan stop. Coba dinyalakan kameranya, kita diskusi dulu. Kita akan diskusi lebih dalam. Ya, kita akan diskusi lebih dalam because you will be an English teacher. Ya, semua yang ada di sini adalah calon guru bahasa Inggris. Nah, kira-kira ya gimana pendapat kalian? Oke. Okay. What's your opinion about your planning? Yeah, in build up or in improving your student. Nah, ini nanti kamu punya rencana seperti apa untuk bangsa ini melalui murid-murid kalian supaya eksistensi keberadaan bahasa Inggris itu bisa dikatakan kalian jadi guru itu benar-benar berkualitas ya. Based on your quality, not your quantity. Hati-hati, kalau kuantitas itu bisa aja nilai IPK itu enggak terlalu apa ya. Gini-gini, maksud saya IPK bagus, but you have bad practice, so it will be a matter. Ya, ini akan jadi masalah juga. Kamu nilaimu bagus sekali, tapi dalam kenyataan prakteknya, you cannot transfer your information well to all your students. Nah, ketika kamu nggak bisa memberikan transfer ilmu kepada para siswa, ini juga menjadi kendala. Nah, pertanyaan saya satu, kira-kira kamu ngajar, kalau nggak mau ngajar reading itu nanti kamu ngajari ya apa? Kamu ngajari apa muridmu? Ayo, itu aja sudah, simple aja pertanyaan saya. My question only simple for you because you will be an English teacher. What kind of way that you have for improving your student English skill based on the critical reading lecture? Fitron. Ayo, Fitron si Ewis. Si laki, cuma satu ya. Fitron doang. Ayo, Fitron. Yes, Fitron, di-onkan mikrofonnya. Kita diskusi aja. Dinyalakan semua mikrofonnya, enggak apa-apa. Ya, kalau selama nggak ada kegiatan, nggak ada suara, dinyalakan aja biar kita diskusinya enak langsung. Yes, Fitron.
For now, I don't have any best strategy for improving my students. But from this class, I got a little plan that I will make my students interest with my teaching, gain their attention, or playing some games or quiz that easy to answer or easy to do for my students. Because when I teach with some hard or advanced question or task or assignments, when my student is not tidak masih belum mampu gitu,
yeah,
atau tidak interest with my assignment, okay, so I will give easier or simpler question or assignment. So
well, thank you. And then Hershey.
Okay, so my plan is I will research about my student first. What level are they? Maksudnya kayak level apa mereka sekarang? So I will apply the material and method that suitable for them. Kalau misalnya they have been in advanced
level,
I will use many textbooks.
Okay.
And then, but if they are in beginner or in middle level, I will use maybe something that having many pictures that yang bikin students interested with their subject, so they will interest in English that much. Sorry.
Okay, thank you. So if I take the point, let us see, say level, and then who is that? Siapa tadi? Fitron ya? Where is Fitron? Go out.
Yes, sir.
Oh ya, yeah, ada ya, masih ada. Tadi yang dikatakan Fitron soal interest ya, interest. Dan Hershey mengatakan level, there are middle, up, and low, like that. So, as the teacher, we have to analyze first. Yes, Hershey? Good.
Yes, sir. Nah,
harus analisa dulu. Itu versinya Hershey dan versinya Fitron. Nah, sekarang versinya Karina gimana?
Maybe I will seem like Harris teacher.
Sama itu ya. Tan, gimana Tan? Ayo, kamu dari Arema, kan Arema kota pendidikan. Cukup isin di sini. Ayo.
Ya. Yeah, I think. Sesuai dengan level apa kelas mereka. Jadi harus. Kalau misalkan dan kita mengajarnya di sekolah apa? Kalau misalkan di sekolah internasional atau sekolah yang sudah maju kan, meskipun sudah kelas 1, apa masih kelas 1, tapi pelajarannya sudah
begitu, sir.
Oke, okay. It is based on your experiences, maybe? Yes. It's based on your experiences or not?
It is based
on experience or not? Itu berdasarkan pengalamanmu sendiri enggak? You say that there are differences between the formal school, there are any type, national, state, and international class. Yes?
Yeah.
You are from international class?
No, of course not.
No, I mean, when you say, because your friend say, Vitron say that where is the position of beginner? It depends on the student receive the first information about the English first, like that, Fitron, okay? Ya kan? Tadi Fitron katakan demikian, ya. Nah, sekarang pertanyaan, ini menarik sekali gitu ya. Jadi yang disampaikan Gagarin, Fitron ini nyambung, dan nyambung juga Karina, nyambung sekarang nyambung kamu. Nah, pertanyaan saya. When you are stay in primary, you stay in state primary? Jadi kamu di SD sudah menerima bahasa Inggris belum? Ayo. 12 maneh nih sama.
Saya dari TK, Sir.
Oh, keren dong. Di mana TK-nya kok sulit bahasa Inggris orang itu?
Cuma kecil apa TK kecil-kecilan gitu, TK muslimat gitu. Tapi sudah ada guru bahasa Inggrisnya gitu.
Mm-hmm. TK kayak TK apa itu? Kok keren loh ini ya.
TK muslimat aja.
TK muslimat. Anu ta, ini apa namanya? Apa di Blimbing itu jenengnya?
Bukan, saya TK muslimat NU9. Jadi dekat rumah aja, Sir.
Oh, gitu. But there is an English teacher ya. Stay from kindergarten. Nah, bayangkan ini sudah TK, sudah kenal bahasa Inggris. Nah, tapi kalau sekarang pengalamannya di Vitron, belum tentu nih saya coba tak tanyain di daerah Bantur sana. Iya enggak? Different or not? Vitron. Kira-kira different enggak?
Quite different, Sir.
Nah, different. Nah, different sekali. Jadi ada banyak perbedaan, there are some differences factor. Yes, the factor is not only from the teacher, not only from quality of the teacher, no, but environment can influence it. Jadi lingkungan pun juga bisa mempengaruhi. Nah, gitu loh. Tapi itu semua juga tergantung dari perkembangan. Enggak sama, ya. Where is the position of the teacher? Makanya sekalipun gurunya hebat, kalau sarana prasarananya agak mendukung, ya tidak bisa. Cannot. Ya. Dan I interest with, tadi siapa yang katakan Gagarin atau Vitron, yang katakan dikasih soal-soal yang mudah-mudah gitu, atau Hershey tadi ya. Ya, ada katakan ada dikasih soal-soal mudah dulu, kalau sulit dikasih yang up level, kalau yang gampang dikasih soal yang mudah, itu siapa tadi yang katakan begitu? Hershey ya?
Me, sir.
Oke, nah. Ini Pak Afon berbagi sebuah pengalaman. Di Belanda, di Jerman, itu sekolah tidak lama. Sekolah cuma 4 jam. Tapi kenapa mereka bisa hebat? Ya, sekolah tidak lama kayak di Indonesia sampai berjam-jam. Bayangkan, anak SD aja sekolah mulai jam 7. Kelas 1 SD jam 11, jam 12 baru pulang. Bahkan ada yang jam 1 pulang. Ya enggak? Coba tuh kamu cari sekolah-sekolah di Malang itu kan banyak. Tan kan bisa kasih informasi itu. Kan sekolah-sekolah yang keren-keren itu rata-rata pulangnya kan siang, hampir sore itu. Iya enggak? Nah itu bayangkan, seorang anak dipaksa belajar sampai segitu banyaknya. Karena yang dipikirkan dalam guru itu konsepnya adalah konsep teori. Ya, ini sama dengan tidak manusiakan manusia dong. Nah gitu ya, kamu harus sebagai mahasiswa harus kritis ini. Apalagi kamu calon guru bahasa Inggris. Jadi jangan sampai lu nanti jadi guru, arek-arek murid-muridmu kok pleter, kok kayak pelajaran sampai koyok ngono. Kasihan mereka. Ya. Jangan seperti itu. Jadi sekarang kan yang diadopsi di Indonesia itu kan kurikulum merdeka. Udah dengar ya semua ya? Merdeka belajar, kurikulum merdeka. Ya itu yang diadopsi adalah model pembelajaran miliknya Jerman dan Belanda. Mengapa demikian? Karena yang diambil dari Belanda itu konsep PBL dan yang diambil dari Jerman adalah konsepnya PJBL. Ini sudah tahu belum PBL PJBL? Enggak tahu. I don't know, Mister. Ya, tak kasih tahu. Jadi PBL itu adalah problem based learning. Ya, pembelajaran berbasis masalah. Maka siswa dituntut memiliki literasi yang sangat tinggi, maka dibiasakan membaca. Nah, mengapa orang Barat, orang Belanda, orang Eropa itu kemana-mana selalu bawa buku? Karena sudah terbiasa, sudah terbangun kebiasaan baca itu. Beda dengan kita yang dibawa apa? HP. Sing dibaca, WA. Wah, itu loh. Makanya aku selalu sering katakan sama kalian. Ya itu bedanya. Ya, beda lagi dengan di Jerman. Apa yang diadopsi kalau dari Jerman yang diadopsi pada kurikulum merdeka adalah PJBL. Apa itu PJBL? Project based learning. Kalau PBL dari problem based learning, kalau PJBL adalah project based learning. Nah, itu ada sintaksnya yang harus kalian kuasai, nanti kamu akan dapat di semester, kalau enggak semester 6, semester berapa itu? 70. Sebelum PBL. PBL semester berapa? Tahun depan ya PBL ya. PBL-mu 2 tahun lagi atau 1 tahun lagi? Halo. You have practice 1 years again, ya. Yeah. 1 tahun ke depan itu kamu sudah PPL atau belum? Belum? Belum ya?
Sepertinya sudah.
Sudah. Nah, kalau sudah berarti semester depan ini berarti. Berarti kamu akan dapat materi itu, nanti kamu akan dapat yang namanya PBL dan PGPL. Perkuliahan itu nanti akan dapat. Nah, itu harus kalian pahami. So, you have to analyze first. Ada kata analisa di sini. Tadi dikatakan oleh Hersi mengatakan analisa. Ya, yeah. Analyze the student. Why? Because the student is different between one and others. Ya, kalau di Jerman dan Belanda, ini sekolah cuma 4 jam, tapi mereka sudah berbasis proyek. Ya, rata-rata demikian. Tidak memberikan materi dalam kelas, tapi di kelas itu adalah memecahkan permasalahan. Forumnya adalah diskusi. Anak SD presentasinya sudah menggunakan PowerPoint yang keren sekali. Dan bayangkan di Indonesia masih di perguruan tinggi. Nah, ini kan tertinggal jauh gitu. Ya. Tertinggal jauh sekali. Nah, di sini teknologi sekarang masih apa namanya? Android. Okelah katakanlah sampai 5G. Android 2018 itu di Jerman sudah enggak ada namanya Android. Yang digunakan adalah mirrorless. Jadi kaca, jadi alat itu, alat pembelajaran itu medianya kayak kaca. Dari kaca disebut mirrorless itu. Jadi kalau misalnya, makanya ketika, ini Pak Ovon juga berbagi pengalaman, ketika anak praktek tentang pembelajaran IPA misalnya, ya IPA tentang organ tubuh, alat itu akan ditempelkan di dalam, di luar begini, ada scannernya gitu. Dan langsung kelihatan detak jantungnya. Indonesia belum punya sampai sekarang. Belum ada. Hologram aja belum ada. Hologram aja paling di kampus-kampus besar. Enggak ada, belum ada. Ya, touch screen yang hologram belum, kita belum punya. Nah, padahal nanti arahnya ke sana. Oleh sebab itu, ya ini arahnya harus ke sana. Maka pemanfaatan use and learn and was it teach by digital approach, you have to need it. Ya, jadi harus dibutuhkan kalian. Pendekatan berbasis teknologi itu juga penting sekali. Jelas ya dari sini ya. Sehingga nggak tertinggal. Bangsa kita itu nggak tertinggal. Ya untungnya masa pandemi sehingga pemanfaatan teknologi lumayan bagus. Tapi jeleknya ya gitu. Pada saat perkuliahan seperti ini, ya ini yang kelihatan wajahnya cuma 3 orang. Cuma Karina, Tans, dan Hersi aja. Udah yang lain off semua. Nah, ini juga mental-mental bangsa yang perlu diperbaiki. Ya, this kind of the character building. Yes. We have to what's that? Repair it. Ya, kita harus perbaiki itu. Ini mentalitas yang enggak bagus. Nah, gitu ya. Kapan bangsa mau maju? Kapan guru mau maju kalau seperti itu? Enggak ada, yang ada keterpurukan nanti. Nah, oleh sebab itu in this section you can think and have what's that, the main point of the critical reading that you have. Nah, jadi critical reading seperti apa? Yaitu ya sekarang dituntut kamu harus mampu berpikir kritis. Contoh nih mengajar ya, mengajar siswa. Ketika nanti mengajar siswa, jangan siswanya disuruh membaca saja, jangan. Kalau misalnya tadi dikatakan si Hersi ada lambang dan seterusnya, ya boleh berikan variasi. Tapi diusahakan semua yang aktif adalah siswa. Maka pembelajarannya harus apa? Harus berbasis pada aktivitas peserta didik. So, all the teaching and learning process have apa? Harus berbasis aktivitas peserta didik. Berarti apa? Have to harus apa? Apa? Berbasis aktivitas peserta didik seperti apa? Ya harus aktif siswanya. Ya, you have to make your student be active, not passively. No, cannot. Ya, jadi guru nanti kalian tugasmu itu bukan kamu yang aktif, bukan. You only the facilitator to all your students. Kamu hanya fasilitator buat para siswa. Itu ya. So jadi dibuat siswanya aktif. Tadi ada katakan ada menggunakan berbagai pendekatan termasuk game dan seterusnya. Itu bagus sekali. Itu rencana-rencana, rancangan-rancangan. But depend on the character of the student and the character of the class. Tapi itu semua nanti akan kembali pada karakter siswa dan karakter kelas. Because one and one is different. Ya, satu dari satu itu pasti berbeda. They are unique, ya. mereka itu unik. Yang dimanfaatkan apanya? Ya kelebihannya. Ya. Which one is positive for you and for the student improving English like that. Ya, apalagi sekarang kurikulum merdeka, sekarang enggak usah bingung lagi kamu cari namanya penyetaraan, enggak usah. Kuliah kamu cukup S1, kamu sudah bisa mengikuti pendidikan prajabatan, PLBG, PPG, ya, pendidikan profesi guru nanti. Ya, sekarang sudah enak aturannya. SD sudah ada bahasa Inggris, kurikulum merdeka sudah diberikan legalisasi. Jadi kamu bisa, ada di kampus ada ya? Buka prodi Kanjuruan, buka prodi PPG, enggak? Program profesi guru? Ada? Is there any profession program for the teacher? Enggak ada. Ada ya?
PGSD atau PGTK gitu.
Oh, gitu. Ya sudah. Bahasa Inggris berarti nanti pasti ada. Nanti didoakan aja supaya nanti kampus cepat buka. Karena nanti itu bagus. Kalau kamu selesai S1, nanti kamu langsung ikut PPG ya. Langsung harus kalau bisa. Nggak usah. Karena kamu nanti ketika kamu mengajar pun, nanti kamu harus PPG. Kalau belum PPG, nanti kamu belum bisa dikatakan you are the professional teacher. Understand? Ya, jadi nanti harus nambah kuliah. Kuliah lagi nanti kamu. Kuliah lagi PPG itu paling nggak 3 semester ya. Nanti 3 semesteran lah paling nggak. Jadi mudah-mudahan nanti ketemu Pak Alfon lagi. PPG, UM ketemu Pak Alfon kok ya. Kuliah anak UM. Oke. Ya wis, itu aja. Kita tadi sudah sampai di mana ya hari ini? Coba dibuka lagi. Masih ada waktukah ini untuk diskusi? Kita tinggal ini aja kan? Ya. Tinggal di
4 minutes again.
Oke, ya udah kalau gitu. Ada berapa waktu? 10 menit ya? 5 menit. 5 menit. Berapa? 4 menit. 4 menit.
4 menit.
Oke, sudah. Gini aja. Nanti kalian sudah dikasih tugas di sepadah itu sama saya. Ya, kalian silakan bikin PowerPoint dan buatlah presentasi. Mengapa saya selalu mengatakan selalu bikin presentasi? Kalau tugas dari Pak Alfon selalu presentasi ya. Because I want my student to be active. Ya kan, kalau tugas sudah diberikan dari saya, maka kamu pasif. Tapi kan sekarang kamu aktif gak sadar. Sadarnya paling sekarang. Oh iya ya, begitu berpikirnya. Oh iya ya, dengan presentasi, dengan bikinnya aku jadi aktif. Yes or not? Nah, kalau kamu sadar berarti itu baik karena semua itu demi untuk meningkatkan kompetensi kalian. Udah itu aja, nanti kalau ada sesuatu bisa ditanyakan, bisa di WA. Pak Alfon kapan aja boleh bebas 24 jam. Kalau ada masalah langsung WA. Ada sesuatu WA, enggak apa-apa. Bebas. Ya, Hirsi, Tan, Karina, Gagarin, Ella, Marcelina, Dea, Tiara, Yumi, Indi. Oke, ya, jelas ya. Nanti kalau ada sesuatu WA saya enggak apa-apa. 24 jam. Pokoknya itu balasnya kapan untuk tadi tak balas, pokoknya tak balas. Yang enggak mungkin kalau pas malam tidur ya enggak mungkin dibalas. Tapi pasti balas di sela-sela kesibukan saya, pasti saya balas.
Yes, sir.
Oke, good. Thank you. Ya udah itu aja, nanti kita akhiri meeting kita. We have to end our meeting in this class and I say thank you very much for you all. You have to be active in next meeting. Jadi minggu depan kita tinggal review aja ya. Oke,
okay,
ya sudah.
Yes, sir.
Coba mudah-mudahan nanti bisa ke Kanjuruan ya, ke kampus ya. Itu aja, saya kira kita akhiri. Terima kasih, selamat sore, dan wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Have a nice day, sir.
Sip.
Thank you, sir.